And welcome back. Where the hell are we? We're in Leia Rhemen again. Like I said at the end of last episode, I wanted to see what was down in here. And we never did.
Let's see what lies this way.
Do that. I'll read it again. This large tunnel curves underneath the floor and continues to the east. It's blocked by glistening ropes of webbing that you might be able to slide past. The walls beneath the webbing feel weak and crumbly. With the proper tools, you might be able to widen the passage. Break through the webbing. You consider the thick, viscous strands. Breaking through them will require considerable strength. Have a dare to it. He's always our strength guy. Swinging and slashing, Adair severs the heavy webs. You clear a passage. The needle-like voice digs into your skull once more. Infiltrating, pursuing, you shall not have it. You hear a hungry chittering. Now, feed. Skittering creatures with gnashing mandibles pour from the walls. Oops. Alright, spiderlings, and unfortunately we're all scattered here. Durance could use some help. We are a little damaged because on the way here we found some more, what do you call it? Dank spores. So we're a little under, as you can see. Hitting that one. Aloth, yeah. Theodas, help out. I'm ready. Yeah, and when they were attacking us, we kept switching to ranged weapons. And that can stop right about now. Thank you. They were taking control of us, those dank spores, and switching us to ranged. Knockdown. Make sure we're all attacking. Hey. Nice. Mm-hmm. Hey, little spiderling! We didn't even make it. Chunkage! Okay. Take two?
My eyes are peeled.
Sticky strands of webbing dangle from the mouth of the tunnel. The passage through it is clear enough. Enter the tunnel.
That's it!
Okay. Alright. Crystal Eater Spiderlings. This thing's gonna be dead shortly enough. Widowmaker. Get rid of all these little ones. I was gonna move these guys around. but too late. What's this say? Shattered crystal crunches and tinkles underfoot.
Keeping an eye out.
Well, there's no way to go there.
No problem.
I know there's a reason I came back here. Or I should come back here. Or I did come back here. Totally hidden section. Oh, it branches off of here, off that central chamber where we found all those bodies. That's right, we couldn't make it across. There was a break. That's interesting, cool. I wonder how much more there is to explore here. Well, there's something in the web. There's the spiders. Spiders there, of course.
Following your lead.
Yeah. Sure.
It's funny, our attack thing doesn't come up. Are we gonna open a dialogue with them? They're not attacking. Well, they see us. I guess there's no more sense in, Great place to be surrounded by frickin' spiders. This is actually creepier than if they were fighting us. Ooh, Nridek? Who that? A robed... Ooh, what the hell are you? A robed, gangling creature lurches toward you, and you feel something needling at your brain again. The screeching hiss that invades your mind is edged with rage. Digging and ferreting animal. It pauses, its mouthpieces clacking. When its words fill your mind again, they're tempered with fear. My legacy. It clutches an egg-like stone in its spindly fingers. The white stone glows with life, and you feel a presence inside. The creature notices your interest. For the colony. It cocks its head. Animal calm. Peaceful. Yes? Its thoughts echo back at you from within the stone. It occurs to you that a piece of the creature's soul is somehow housed within it. What are you doing with that stone? Legacy. Colony. Its segmented mouth parts scrape together. Young are always few, slow to hatch, fragile. The creature indicates itself with a hairy appendage. Last of colony. Soon to die. It draws the stone closer to its narrow chest. Long-dead animals put spirit stuff in metal. It points behind it. I keep spirit stuff in stone. Take the new colony. Colony alone is weak, young, frail, empty of wisdom. But two colonies together survive. Make strong colony. Huh. Are we gonna parley with these spiders? It strokes the stone. Need legacy to guide new colony. Keep it strong. Alright, is it doing anything wrong? I mean, what's the soul? Do we want to let the soul free? Well, do these things have a right to live? Of course they do. Even though they've been fighting them the entire game, on and off. Well, 1 and 2 are basically the same. I like the sentiment, though. Go, and may there be peace between our kinds. I doubt there ever will. They're freaking spiders. Its unkindling eyes stare back at you. Warm relief gushes into your mind. Knows peace and gentleness, it does. Nridek, go. Bring legacy. Many thanks. Bye-bye. You left your friends. Only Nridek goes.
Time to see and not be seen.
Let's see if this thing is trapped. Unless we might be attacked for opening it. Ooh, Claude Haliath. You guys don't need a spear, do you? +5 accuracy. This bronze spear appears to have been crafted with great care. Despite the weapon's age, the point is remarkably sharp. Adra details line the grip, and runes are carved into the shaft. You feel the Adra core running through the weapon. We needed an Adra... For upstairs. An Adra weapon. Okay, they're not attacking. Good sign. Stop sneaking now, I guess. Alright. Oh! Hidden thingy! Something new.
See now what the flame has shown us?
Girdle of Mortal Protection. We have that, don't we? What the hell is this? Adra Eniac? Not currency in the traditional sense. Eniacs are awarded to Glamfellens for noteworthy deeds. They are palm-sized, intricately carved discs of Adra that commemorate the deeds of the recipient. Cool. Well, we got 112 of them. Now value 18 copper for one, or for all 112 together? Yeah, so it's not really... Kidding me? We can't even put that in? Wait a second. Did we put it in? I think one of us has a girl of more. Yes. In fact. He does. Some of us might be missing a belt. Durance does. So does Canna. We gave Canna the last thing. Let's keep our healer alive. Now where's the stuff we pick up? I couldn't put it in... Why I have a regular rod there. Alright, let's go. Let's see if we can get back up this tunnel. Let's see what we can do here. I need a soul vessel, right? Bearing soul vessel and a weapon with a heart of Adra. The warrior may then approach the urn. In this way he shall fashion an arm worthy of his skills and ambitions. An arm meaning like a sword? Well, we need a soul vessel, so I guess we're gonna be back here at some point. Okie dokie. Continue on to Twin Elms. Twin Elms, here we come. This stuff is marked, but we can't do anything with it. Right? No. We know it's going to have some significance. And if we can't do anything with it now, we will be doing something with it at some point. Hearthsong, here we come. Okay, cool. Palisade gate. Oh, there's a celestial sapling that we have to deliver that thing to. The dying monk gave us. The Glamfellen home goes on to Hearthsong district. Elms Reach district. The passage of the six. Builder's hearth. Glamfellen home. Hearthsong district. Another Glamfellen home. And the Hearthsong market. Awesome. Quest updated. Search Twin Elms for signs of Thais. The city has a front gate. With any luck, someone saw him when he passed through. I'll have to ask around. Will do. See, no need to sneak at this point. Doubt there's going to be anything hostile or hidden. Oh. There's a Stelgar sitting there. Estremor, still.
Hail, Estremor.
The warrior saunters over, a sneer of suspicion visible beneath streaks of paint. He glances at your gear before favoring you with a long look. Another fugitive from the burning city? The six tribes of Ir Glanfath welcome you to Twin Elms. Before you lies the Hearthsong district. You are free to explore it, but do not let your feet stray into the other districts. Those are forbidden to Estremorn. Well, you know we gotta do that, then. Why is it forbidden to enter the remaining districts of Twin Elms? Twin Elms is a sacred city, built where the first keepers of the stone met the builders. It exists alongside the works of the builders, and it is the only place in all of Ir Glanfath where it is permitted to set foot among these sacred places. The Estremorin, however, do not have proper respect for the stones here. His words trigger something in your memory. You see an image of a perfect cube of Adra. Just as quickly, the image fades. A leader of one of the tribes could give you the permission of the city. Only Anamemphath Bethwell is present in the passage of the six today, and she has her own troubles. He jerks his head at a long hut in the middle of the district. Passage of the six, I guess. You have other questions about Twin Elms? I haven't heard of the Keepers of the Stone. The oldest of the six tribes. He points the tip of his sword at a long hut behind him. Up the stairs and into the passage of the six. This is where our Anamemphatha gather. Great, because we needed another syllable for that. Bethwell, the Anamemphath of the Guided Compass, can tell you more. What can you tell me about Twin Elms? The city is sacred to all Glanfathans, as it is the place where our ancestors first encountered the Builders. That fated meeting turned our people from generations of wandering to a permanent home among the Builders' relics. When the Builders commanded us to settle here, they allowed us the unique privilege to live among their structures here. It is the only place in Ir Glanfath where this is permitted. The sacred city is divided into four districts. Hearthsong, the common district, Hearthsong, the site of our temples, Elm's Reach, home of the Lemkin and Druids, and the Burial Isle, which is the most sacred place in the city. I'd like to hear about Hearthsong. This is Hearthsong. It's a place where Glanfathans and Estremorin may gather together. It is also the site of the Passage of the Six, where our tribal leaders, the Anamphatha, meet. He points to a large round building at the other end of the district. That way is the market. Guard your purse there. No one bargains like a Glanfathan. And if you need a place to stay, follow the fence to the east. There you will find the way to the Celestial Sapling. Tell me about Elm's Reach. There lies Tir Evron, one of the only towers of the builder still in perfect condition. Two great elm trees twine around it. Even the mightiest works of the gods protect the works of the builders. Two Dlemgan sisters dwell there now. The Hall of Warriors stands at the other end of the district. Rumor has it that Anamphath Simak of Three Tusked Stelgar is there now. We gotta go there. I mean, you gotta give us permission, otherwise I guess we have to fight our way through the whole frickin' district. Which could be interesting. Elm's Reach is also where the Druids keep their halls. There are the ovates of the Golden Grove and Ethic Knoll of Blood Sands. Many shudder at the brutal sacrifices of the Ethic Knoll, but High Ovate Arona is just as powerful in her own way. Do you know anything about Burial Isle? It is the place where our Anamphatha are laid to rest among stones placed by the builders. They say the souls of some of the Anamphatha linger there still. The way lies to Hearthsong. It is the holiest place in all of Twin Elms. Which temples lie in Hearthsong? There is Noonfrost, I like that, which is dedicated to Rimmergand. A group of pale elves from the frozen Southlands arrived not long ago to oversee it. There is also the Nest, the Temple of Hylea, and Galloway's Maw, a den of beasts dedicated to the Hunter God. The route to the Burial Isle also lies that way. So he's telling us where all these places and how to get there, but we're not allowed to go there. That's all I wanted to know about the city. Oh shit. My 5 key sticks. Best that you keep your visit brief. Word has reached our ears that the riots have ended and the gates of Defiance Bay have opened once more. Oh good. I want to ask you about the builders though. Who are the builders? You know them as the Ingwithans. To us, they are the builders, creators of the sacred places that we guard to this day. Interesting. A nimble tongue carries more sting than any blade. True. Anything out around this way we could look at? No. I'll get stuck now. I hate that.
So, this is Twin Elms, home to the 6 tribes of Air Glanfoth, and some very good hides from what I hear.
Don't let the Stelgar hear you say that. A hunter. Mind your manners, foreigner, and be welcome. We live in peace, but we'll never submit to the Estremorin. Guard your tongue around 3 Tustelgar. They are also quick to anger. There's something we can gather here. Hope they don't mind that. Your cap. Concerned tribeswoman. It did happen. The warriors saw the strange man break into Tir Evron. How could the Estremor intrude? What is it doing? Intruder sneak over the grounds of Elm's Reach. I assure you, they saw the man break into Tir Evron. An Orlin dressed in thick furs appears immersed in conversation. He locks his hands together to emphasize his point. I speak true. He commanded strange powers, they claim. An elven woman lifts her eyes from her furry companion and nods in your direction. Another foreigner. Did he look like this one? The Orlin turns around.
Many blessings, traveler.
Or what is it, Estremor? What's Tir Evron? Tir Evron has stood since the time of the builders, and it will stand long after we're all gone. The man says yes, the tower stands strong, and the gods live within its sacred hall. The woman says it's no place for unclean souls, or foreigners. You said the gods live in Tir Evron. How is that possible? The mysteries of our ancestors are not for every foreigner to understand. In Twin Elms, in the temples of the builders, the gods commune with us. Be sated in knowing this truth. Tell me about the man you speak of. A strange man, a foreigner, broke into Tir Evron, the tower under the giant elms. Theas, perhaps? Estremorin cannot walk the grounds of Elm's Reach. Why was he allowed to pass? This one was unseen. He wielded a strange power, we now know, said the tribesman. Foreigners are forbidden from going deeper into the city. They said that Anna Memfath Bethwell, currently presiding in the passage of the Six in the middle of Hearthsong, could grant me entry to other districts. Okay, good. I don't remember him saying that. Glamfellens of Twin Elms have heard of a mysterious man, a foreigner, that recently broke into one of their forbidden districts, Elms Reach. Okay, so we need to get in here to find him. Tribesmen. Adam Fatha oversee Twin Elms from the passage of the Sixth. Make yourself useful. You're within our hearth now. What if I don't want to make myself useful? There's kids! I've never met an Estramor before. And neither has he. They're gonna follow us around, that's awesome. I like that. Kids following us all over. Observe as we mightily pick this reed. Yeah. Old song reminds us of our past and the builder's footprint. I'll leave that, of course. Definitely not worth it. Yeah, I'm content with looking around outside for now. The water is cool and crisp. Beware of your candor among the merchants. That ogre keeps looking at me like I urinated on some ruins. What ogre? Well, that's a celestial sapling. Does she take me for a fool? This will not stand. I have been swindled, etc. What's that? Renato. And a noble. Helea's tits? The drinks they serve here might as well be drinking lamp oil. Renato says she'll pay. That wits, she'll. Fuming with anger and pacing in tiny circles, the Valian merchant aims his wild rant at you as you approach. You there! Have you come to trade with the savages? Learn from my example and take your business elsewhere. Spittle accents his every sentence. Liars, cheats, swindlers. That duplicitous bitch Elari? She claimed to be selling Elard Gola flower buds. But all I have now is 6 bushels of common houseplants. The herbs are useless. He throws a handful of dried plants to the ground, stomping on the brittle stems and leaves, kicking up pungent, savory scents. I'll get my money back from that swindling savage. What is Elard Gola? Renato's rage abates for a moment, and his face twists into a nervous smile. Elard Gola is a plant that grows in the jungles of Ir Glamfath. When dried and consumed or brewed into a tea, it's known to enhance one's strive for the better pleasures in life. You tested the remedy on yourself, didn't you? Well, Renato fidgets in place, his hands smoothing the creases in his tunic. How can I sell a remedy if I have not tested? Of course I try the herb. Imagine what could have happened if I peddled this pale imitation. Renato clears his throat. His voice grows quiet. The herb did not have the intended effect. The only thing it made hard was not vomiting. What did Lalari say when you confronted her? Nothing of substance, he quickly mutters. She defended herself, of course, saying the herbs were legitimate. Why wouldn't she lie? No one will value my word over hers. Patui! Lalari can lie with impunity when surrounded by her gangs of savage thugs. What do you intend to do about this? When I get my hands on Renato halts his sentence, his eyes darting about at the nearby Glamfellen guards. I'm in the savage's home court, so it's my word against hers. Where does that leave me? I'd be a fool to threaten her here, on tribal soil. Well, you almost did. He presses on his temples. I cannot sell this worthless herb to recover my coin, and I am powerless to confront Ilari. I don't suppose... He looks at you, sizing you up. If you are willing to mediate, perhaps you could succeed where I failed. I would, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. I'll see what I can do. Aphrodisiac plant gathered in the deep jungles of Irglanfa.
How do you do?
Renato smiles broadly and throws his arms in the air at your arrival. My friend, welcome back. Have you recovered my coin? I have not left. See what you have for sale? Renato looks away from you, searching his neck and shifting his feet. I am destitute and have but a few meager offerings left to sell. How dreadfully embarrassing. If I can recover my investment from Ilari, I'll have funds to resupply my stores. Until then, you are welcome to take a look at what I still have in stock. Bunch of herbs, of course. Alright. Don't need any of that at this time. You gotta talk to these guys. We'll save that for next episode, and we'll look around the rest of this area. I'll explore the entire outside before I go into buildings and such. It'll take us a couple episodes to explore all this, I'm gathering. So, thanks for watching, and see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.